Hello, I have just received something from banggood.com, and I have to say, I am absolutely thoroughly impressed with this item. It's a bug detector. The link will be in the description if you're interested to look. And it has a ridiculously good spec. I've tried three or four different bug detectors over the years just to try them out, see what they're like. And this one has absolutely dropped my jaw with how good it is. So here's the manual. Let's see if we can get this to focus. You can always pause that and have a little look. It's got a really good range of detection, as you can see there at the bottom, 1 MHz to 12 GHz. It can also detect, visibly detect cameras. And it can also detect the strong magnetic force that's used with GPS trackers that are stuck to cars. So, what do you get? You get the main unit, which is the thing that you mainly use to do your detecting. You get a special kind of antenna that has a light on the end that you use for detecting the magnetic strength. You get a charger with a USB cable, but it's not a normal USB, it's got a specialized, like a normal DC type of connector at the end. You get a micro USB cable, a little tiny one, to charge up this device, which you use to visibly detect cameras. Now, here's the theory behind this, and it really does work. When you shine a light at a lens is like a domed surface. So when light hits it, it kind of bounces back at the exact same direction it came from. So what you do is, there's only one button on this. You look through this side, and that side where the lights are, you point away towards the area you're checking. You press this button on the side, and it shines extremely bright red LEDs. I think they say that they're lasers. I don't know if they are, but I wouldn't go looking into them. So now what you do is, with the lights facing away from you, you look through this window, and if you start seeing flashing back a bright white glint, that means that there's light reflecting back at you, and you should get a closer look, because maybe it's a glass bowl, or maybe it's a camera. And I will be showing you most of these functions working, if not all of them. You press this button on the side, you can change it from a fast blink to a slow blink, to a solid on, and you literally just look through this and just look around the room, making sure you look straight through, and that's how you can detect cameras, and then press it again for off. Really nice little tool. There's the charging port there. Okay, so this is the main unit. You've got two modes. You've got radio frequency on the left, and you've got magnetic on the right. When you're using the radio frequency, you use this antenna. And you turn the knob on here, and this is also the sensitivity. Now I'm going to have to try to shield this because you can't see the LEDs properly on the camera. There we go. All right, so when I turn this up, you can see the LEDs go up. Now, here's the thing. You turn it down again just enough until it stops moving up the scale. Now, this is sensitive enough that you can go around a room, and if there's something transmitting somewhere, you're going to get a good indication that there's something somewhere nearby that's transmitting. So then, to narrow it down, you go back in and you change the sensitivity again. You turn it down again when you're closer. And then you get a little bit, you keep scanning around the area, and you can see, okay, well, it's definitely in that side of the room. So then you come back while you're still in that area, while it's going berserk, right? Then you turn the sensitivity down a bit more. And you're getting closer and closer until I've just found the Wi-Fi router. And it really does help you to get a direction of where the actual thing is. You just have to narrow it down. Like, it's somewhere over there, it's somewhere over there, it's in that corner. And then you get like, oh, it's in the alarm clock. And that's not very good. So yeah, this is going to be really good for people that are going on holiday, because you never know unscrupulous people may have put bugs in rooms and transmitters and things. It's kind of creepy. But this is way the best one I've ever seen and tested. Right, so that's that function. When you want to do the magnetic one, which will mostly be useful for like checking the wheel well in your car and things, if someone's like slapped a GPS tracker on there, I'm sure most people don't have to worry about this kind of thing. But what you do is you flick this switch over into magnetic. You turn the sensitivity on full. You connect this antenna, and then you have to balance the LED until it hits right in the middle on number 5 by using this other knob. And once it's at 5, it'll stop beeping, and that's when you're able to go scanning around. So, let's turn it on full. Okay, put the antenna in, and then balance this with the other knob. Oop, too far. Right, so now it's in the middle. And you may have the odd little blip of false positive. It's because it's going to be as good as how you're able to calibrate it to stay in that middle number 5. We get a light on the end to do detection. And you can just go around scanning. And if you find any strong magnetics, let's see. Yeah, so I've got a hard drive magnet, and it detects that. So I will be showing you little clips of these capabilities working, but I just wanted to show you the basics of how it functions. And really, this is, I'm being very genuine, this is the best thing I've ever seen for being able to detect signals that's within a decent price range. This is just such a really cool thing to have. It's a nice gadget, but it's also at the same time a really useful tool if you're genuinely concerned that someone's kind of being a bit unscrupulous and spying on you. So there you go. Let's have a little look next at how it works, like seeing it working. Okay, so let's do a little bit of a test of the frequency detection. Over here I have the main unit, and over there is a Wi-Fi router. Now, I am kind of close to this, but this is just going to demonstrate the process. So, what I do is I turn it on, turn it up until it goes berserk, make sure it's in radio frequency mode, then turn the sensitivity down. Now, because this is going to be highly sensitive, if there's any phones in the area, like the thing I'm recording on, there may be the odd blip here and there, but for the purposes of this test, it's at its maximum sensitivity, because I've only just turned it down to the point where it stops going berserk. So it's going to go off quite easily. Oh, there's something over there. Yeah? So it's like letting me know the kind of general direction. So if I get a little closer and it's picking it up, I turn the sensitivity down a bit. And I know it's somewhere in that area, wherever this hidden thing is that's transmitting. So now I've turned the sensitivity down, I can get a bit closer in that area and narrow it down. And if it was a bigger area I'm checking, obviously, then I'd turn it down a bit more, get a bit closer, turn it down a bit more, get a little closer. But as you can see, it is clearly detecting a really strong signal. So I'd be like, okay, if that's an alarm clock, why is my alarm clock in this hotel room broadcasting a signal like that with this kind of strength? Possibly it's because some peeping Tom has put a camera in there looking at you while you sleep. That's not creepy, is it? So that's the radio frequency checking capability. Let's have a look at the camera detection next. Okay, so now we know how to deal with detecting where the transmitter is, because the transmitter means that somebody could be anywhere in the area and you wouldn't actually know. But you can also visibly detect them using this. So you press the button on the side to activate the lights. You look through the thing. And if I press it again to make it go a bit slower, it might be easier for you to notice. But you should be able to see if I can get it to focus. It's a bit difficult for the camera to focus. But in the middle, let's do it this way. Right, so the light is flashing, but in the middle of the actual lens itself, like while I'm not at the same angle, there's nothing flashing to me other than just a red light. But because the lights are flashing at the same direction that you're looking through the viewfinder, you can see that there's a white glowing orb over there. So once you see that, now you get closer to that to inspect it. Maybe it's a glass bowl, it could be a vase, it could be, you know, a ball bearing that someone left, you know, whatever. But you get closer and you have a look, and then you'll notice that it's actually a camera. So if I focus in on here, this is just a webcam. But you can clearly see that's what it looks like. A bright glowing orb. And even though it's looking over there, you can still see it because, as I said, when the LEDs are flashing, it's coming back at the same angle. So if the camera can see you, you'll be able to detect it with this. So that is rather a handy thing. So let's press it again, turn it off. Let's have a little look at the magnet detection. Okay, so as I said, the other function is to be able to detect the strong magnetic force that's needed to keep a GPS tracker stuck to a metal vehicle. So what we do is we flip this switch over into magnet mode, turn it on full, put this in, and then balance it. So turn it on full sensitivity. Balance it to 5. Okay, so now it's balanced at 5. You got a light on the end. Now that is a hard drive magnet. A very strong magnet, but still not quite as strong as I imagine they use with GPS trackers. So you'd be checking like the wheel well everywhere. You're like, oh, what's that? And the purpose of the light is so that if you visibly see something you're kind of suspicious about, then you get closer to that thing. And you're like, oh, there's something up there. There's a strong magnet. So then you could reach in and pull the thing out. And if you're curious, this is what a hard drive magnet looks like. Very strong magnet. So you can detect magnets. Oops, if I change the mode. So you can detect magnets, radio frequency, and cameras, all with one package. That's why this has really stumped me for how good this is. I didn't think it would be anywhere near as good as this, but it's definitely the best one, and I've tried at least 4. Including this, and this is by far the most sensitive, the most useful, the most feature-packed. Like, you get, normally you get like this kind of thing built in, but the signal detection is not that great, and you certainly don't get magnet detection. So if you want a bug detector and you don't want to spend heaven and earth trying to buy it, spending an arm and a leg, then get this, because this is really effective. So there you go. Hopefully you found this interesting or useful. Please like and subscribe, and I will see you on whatever the next video happens to be about. Thank you.